My dear Frodo, you asked me once if I had told you everything there was to know about my adventures. It began long ago, in a land far away to the east. There was the city of Dale, peaceful and prosperous. For this city lay before the doors of the greatest kingdom in Middle-earth. Erebor. Stronghold of Thrall, king under the mountain, mightiest of the dwarf lords. His line lay secure in the lives of his son and grandson. All would pay homage to him, even the great elven king, Thranduil. Ah, Frodo, Erebor.
My liege, our king asks you to go and oversee today's mining operation.
Built deep within the mountain itself, the beauty of this fortress city was legend. wealth lay in the earth, in precious gems hewn from rock, and in great seams of gold, running like rivers through stone. The skill of the dwarves was unequaled, fashioning objects of great beauty out of diamond, emerald, ruby, and sapphire.
Huh?
ever they delve deeper down into the dark. And that is where they found it. The Arkenstone, the heart of the mountain. But Thror's love of gold had grown too fierce. A sickness had begun to grow within him. And where sickness thrives, bad things will follow. The first they heard was a noise like a hurricane.
Balin! Sound the alarm!
What is it?
Dragon!
He was a fire drake from the north. This city of men was nothing. For dragons covered gold with a dark and fierce desire. Smaug had come. Death was dealt that day.
Woo!
Of his kin against the wrath of the dragon. No help came from the elves that day, nor any day since. The young dwarf prince never forgave, and he never forgot. That, my dear Frodo, is where I come in. In a hole in the ground, there lived a hobbit.